summer storm appeared. Corky got afraid when it started to rain. Then we came upon a house. Should we go and fly?
Episode 52, Homeward Bound.
My name was Onesimus, and I was Philemon's servant until 2 years ago when I fell in love with his beautiful daughter, Mariam. I think she loved me too, but her brother, Tarius, disapproved.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Tarius!
You stop that!
Don't interfere! You're only a servant. Servant! Don't forget that.
You were cruel to Onesimus.
Tarius's cruelty drove me to seek revenge. After causing an accident that almost killed Tarius, I stole some jewels and fled.
Look out for those burning branches!
Look!
Poor chap. He's a goner.
Flying House made it as far as Corinth this time.
Yeah. But all we went forward in time is a couple of years.
Sometimes I worry that Professor Bumble's never going to be able to get the Flying House back to the 20th century.
Where there is a will, there is a way, don't forget.
I think it was lunch that we forgot.
For sure. That's what I was just about to say, matter of fact.
You nincompoop!
Uh-oh.
You simple-minded baboon!
Wonder what's going on over there.
Come on, let's go see.
Right.
Can't get it to budge. It's stuck.
Get it unstuck, you fool.
Trying as hard as I can.
You whining good for nothing. Push, lazy bones.
Oh, please, please, master.
Shall we lend a hand?
Yeah.
This job calls for robot power.
Careful.
Get away from here. Better mind your own business if you know what's good for you.
Hello there, Mr. Neiman.
You whip that defenseless boy again, I'm personally going to make you regret it, you vicious brute.
I beg your pardon, but that boy's my servant, O'Neiman.
I don't care if he is. Treat him decently or I won't lend one more cent to you.
Not that. Please, I'll obey your wishes.
God!
Who's that? All right, from now on, you be a kinder master. Here.
Yes, sir.
Spend this money to hire someone to help the boy.
Thank you. I will. Believe me, I will.
See that you do.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Hey, you okay?
Can we get you something?
Onesimus. He seems kind of familiar.
He reminds me of Onesimus.
Who was he?
He's real important and wealthy, but he's always protecting poor downtrodden servants like myself.
You hear that?
Yeah.
Do you happen to know where he lives?
In the big vineyard west of town on the Sparta Road.
Let's go. You wanna? Onesimus!
Huh?
Hi there!
Good to see ya. You're Onesimus. Onesimus, right?
Even though you've changed a little, we knew that it was you.
I'm glad you weren't all burnt up.
You children don't know me. My name is Onemon, see?
What?
And I'm certain we haven't met.
Strange.
Yeah.
I doubt if this man's who you think.
Probably not, but he did resemble him.
That's for sure, but from all reports, it wouldn't seem as if Onesimus could be alive.
And there wasn't any scar on Onesimus' face like that.
Guess this fella must have got burned sometime.
Now that's funny.
What do you mean it's funny?
It's odd, because fire was the cause of Onesimus' death, as I recall it.
Yeah, it was a fire. His body was never found.
Neither were the jewels which he stole from Marion's father.
If Onesimus is still alive, Marion should be told.
Why don't we go pay a visit to Marion in Rome so we can tell her we think we found him?
I'm ready if you are.
Let's go.
Three, two, one.
Let's go.
I'm Onemon, not Onesimus. Onesimus died 2 years ago.
Is there something the matter, sir? Aren't you feeling well?
I'm just tired, but I have to leave for Rome.
Must you leave this evening?
Get my carriage ready so I can leave at once.
Yes, master.
My employer will be here in Rome in 2 days. You must vacate these premises by the time he arrives.
Oh, please don't throw us out of our house. We have no place else we can go.
Derek, remember, Father helped you many a time before he became so sick.
I haven't forgotten about it, but I can't let my personal feelings interfere with my job. You owe this much to my employer. Pay up or else you must go.
Oh, no.
Good day.
He's merciless.
I'm sorry, children.
Oh. Father!
I got you into this predicament.
Father, don't get upset.
It isn't your fault.
It is. I got sick and lost my business, and now we'll lose our home.
Marion!
Oh, Onesimus, if only you were here to help us. Flying house.
Look, there's Marion.
Hi, Marion.
Hello. You've come back to Rome.
Hi.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hi.
We can't pay him, so he's putting us out of our house.
Oh, that's dreadful.
Golly, what a cruel, heartless man he must be to take advantage of your father when he's been sick.
The Lord will punish him for being so mean to you.
I think I'm being punished by him myself.
Why?
Huh?
For the wrongs I did Onesimus.
Now, you agreed to forget about the past.
Especially that awful day 2 years ago.
Yeah, when you got hurt. They said Onesimus stabbed your horse and made him throw you.
They were sinful to hurt each other, both Onesimus and my brother.
But I drove him to it with cruel mistreatment.
Who's this man who's being so cruel to you?
It's some ingrate named Derek.
Oh, he just does what he's told by this important man in Corinth who's named Onemon, Justin.
Who?
No.
But Onemon's the name of the man that we...
Have you met him?
No, we haven't. Right, Justin? Well, it's about time for us to be getting back home now. Bye!
All right, excuse us.
Thanks. How come we're leaving before dessert? And what was the big idea pinching me like that, Auntie?
to stop you so you wouldn't blame that we know a Neiman.
Thought that was why you asked to come visit here.
Well, how do you think Marion would feel if we told her on Neiman's Onesimus?
I think she'd be happy to hear he was. Or would she?
He's the one who's throwing them out.
Come on, I'll race you back to the flying house.
Okay. Wait for Corky.
Welcome, O'Neiman. Your carriage awaits.
All right, all right.
Oh? Are you feeling unwell, sir? A touch of mal de mer, perhaps?
Shut up and drive.
Oh, yes, sir.
Have you followed my instructions?
Yes, but I had trouble with the Philemons.
Huh? What's that?
They were told to be out of the house by today, but they haven't left yet. Pardon me for asking, sir, but why do you want their house so badly?
You mind your own business. What's going on there?
Paul is preaching the word of the Lord.
The Lord? He won't help you even if he exists. Romans, you shall be saved if you confess the Lord Jesus, if you believe God has raised him from the dead. Jesus was crucified to save you. Brethren, whoever shall call upon the name of the Lord God shall be saved.
Oh, Neiman, sir?
Yeah?
Want to stop and listen?
Why?
To learn how to ask forgiveness for our sins.
Me? Why should I ask forgiveness? I'm not guilty of any sins.
Sorry, sir. Just thought I'd ask.
What do I care about God anyway? He's done nothing for me. Nothing. I don't need him. Gold. That's what I care about. I'll never have to be anyone's servant again. Who's that? Come in.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, what is it?
There's a young woman outside who says she wants to see you, Neiman.
A young woman?
Yes, sir.
Tell her to come in.
Yes, sir. All right, miss. You can go in.
Thank you.
Don't just stand there. What is it you want?
I want to see Mr. O'Neiman.
You're speaking to him.
My name is Marion, and I'm Philemon's daughter. I want to beg a favor, sir. My father's been very ill, which is why we haven't any money. You can't put my father out of his home while he's helpless. If you believe in the Lord as we do ourselves, have mercy. Forgive us.
I don't believe in the Lord, and I don't have any mercy. No one's ever shown me any mercy.
Your voice. Why, it's so familiar.
You're mistaken. You've never met me.
Could it be? Why, of course. You're Onesimus.
Stay back. I'm not Onesimus. I told you we haven't met.
Why are you trying to hide from me? I know it's you.
The man you're talking about's dead. My name is O'Neiman.
You're resentful because you were so hurt by us. You can't forgive us. I wouldn't blame you for that. Yet...
Well, have you finished?
What?
Now, if you cannot pay your loan off by tomorrow, you'll have to give up your house to me. Excuse me, I have work to do.
No. Wait. Onesimus.
I don't believe in the Lord, and I don't have any mercy.
Oh, Onesimus, if you don't believe in the Lord, you won't be saved from your sins.
Father, wait.
Huh?
Look.
Father, you're not strong enough to be out of bed.
I've got to find the strength somehow to confront that O'Neiman and plead with him for mercy.
Let me speak to him instead.
Tarius, what's happening?
Oh, hello, children. That man named O'Neiman arrived here in Rome today, we're informed.
Really?
Yeah.
Which means we'll be put out on the streets tomorrow.
I think we should go try and talk some sense into him.
Yeah, he's being mean.
I've already talked to him.
Huh?
It's hopeless.
You saw him?
Uh-huh.
Oh, then you must know.
Marion, wait!
Wait!
I'll sacrifice myself to save his soul.
Marion!
Oh, Lord, please forgive Onesimus.
Marion!
No, let me die. It's the only way to get Onesimus to repent of his sins.
Why do I keep having that terrible nightmare? Since I got treated with cruelty, just because I was a mere servant, I was justified in wanting revenge.
If you were, then why do you feel so guilty that you dream about it?
No, it's you again. Get out of here. I told you we've never met.
You're lying, Onesimus.
I'm not Onesimus. I've changed into a different person.
Takes more than switching names, you know. Wiping out your past won't erase your sins.
You've made a mistake in the past. It was bad enough. But if you want God to forgive you, stop making mistakes that are even worse.
The shameful way you treated Marion when she came to talk to you today has driven her to despair. She loves you. She almost drowned herself because of you.
What?
In spite of you treating her family mean, she wanted to save your soul.
Marion was planning to sacrifice her life in hopes that you'd repent of your sin.
Mm-hmm.
Get out of here.
Okay, we'll leave, because I'm sure you've got some things to think about.
Just go!
Onesimus.
Leave.
In a minute. If you're troubled and need advice, why not go see the Apostle Paul?
Good advice.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go.
Marion, you love me, and I harden my heart against you. I harden my heart against God.
Oh.
Paul, I've come to you because I want to repent of my sins. I tried to harden my heart against God, but now I need him. I've broken his commandments. 2 years ago, I stole some jewels from my own master and ran off from him. I was responsible for injuring Philemon's son. I've been revengeful and cruel.
Don't despair, for the Lord will forgive you for your sins. Call on the name of Lord Jesus and he'll save you. He loves you.
Oh, but I've denied him.
I denied him myself and persecuted him, but he made me his minister and taught me to open the eyes of unbelievers like you, that you may receive forgiveness of sins.
But the Philemons couldn't forgive me.
I'm certain they will. They're Christians. I'll be happy to write to Philemon myself in your behalf.
Oh, Paul, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry, Father. I did my best, but Onesimus wouldn't relent.
If only he'd been willing to wait till I regained my health.
God forgive him.
Hello, Marion!
Oh, you've come back, children.
Guess what? You won't have to leave your home here after all.
What?
Why not? What happened?
Well, we discovered that Onesimus was actually Onesimus all along.
What?
Onesimus?
My former servant.
Right. We gave him our word that we'd give you this special delivery.
A letter?
I can't believe he could be alive.
Wonder what he's doing this minute.
He's up on Sunset Hill waiting for you to meet him.
Yeah, he said to give you that message.
You mean he really does want to see me now?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
This letter seems to be from the Apostle Paul. Here, my vision's getting poor, so would you read it to me, Tarius?
Yes. From Paul, a servant of Jesus Christ, to Philemon, our dearly beloved and fellow worker, grace be to you and peace from God,
God
our
Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ. For love's sake, I beg you to welcome my son Onesimus, whom I'm sending back to you. In times past, he was unprofitable to you, but now he's profitable to both of us. Receive him as myself, not as a servant, but a brother beloved, both in the flesh and in the Lord.
That's sweet.
Makes me want to go back and see my family like Onesimus has.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Hey!
It's the time machine. We've had to repair it so much, you get fed up with us.
We cannot make it stop shaking.
Come on, time machines don't have feelings. I'm fed up with it. Good for nothing.
Stop it, Justin. You'll break it.
It's useless.
Stop it.
Beware. I am Super Robot and I am taking over.
You've got berserk. Control your
super robot. Obey me. I am your master. Take us back to the 20th century this instant, or I will really lose my temper.
Rest of the kids all right?
Yeah.
Yeah, but no thanks to you, sir.
Why? What have I done?
What?
Huh?
Oh.
What's wrong with the professor?
Maybe he's still dizzy.
I'll go see.
What?
Was it a Justin? It must be catching.
Come here.
What is it?
Huh?
No, you're really back home thanks to the brilliant invention that... Ow!
Wait, the wolves were not dreaming.
The time has come to say goodbye. Goodbye to Corky Roberts, to Angela Roberts, Professor Humphrey Bumble, Sir the Solar Ion Robot, Justin Casey, and to the Flying House.